I remember the time when I had memorized the phone numbers of friends and family. I also used to be pretty good at mental math. But then came smartphones, and I noticed how I rarely make an effort to remember things because, hey, I can just look them up. So, is smart technology making us dumb? Let's find out. This is GMF Compact. Our beloved smartphones, tablets, computers, how would we survive the day without them? But do these gadgets make us stupid? Are we losing the ability to think, memorize, and problem solve? Well, the answer is no. Yes, there are negative impacts of us clinging to our smartphones the whole day. Technic, distraction, anxiety, excessive screen time in the evening may mess with our sleep. But in a recent study from the University of Toronto, researchers came to the conclusion that while technology changes our cognitive abilities, it doesn't harm them. The researchers point out that we now have the ability to outsource tasks. So instead of figuring out how to navigate from one place to another, we can just use GPS. Instead of solving a complex mathematical problem, we can let our smartphones do that for us. This frees up the mind to deal with other tasks. Researchers see our smartphones as some kind of an extension of our brain, so essentially making us into a smarter being. Now, everything I said generally applies to young adults and adults. When it comes to children, the story is a bit different. Debates are ongoing about what's best for the brains of little ones when they are learning to read and write. The good old pencil, paper, and printed books, or tablets with learning apps. Well, studies suggest that children who spend more time on screen than talking to actual human beings suffer in their language development. As children grow older, digital devices become part of their learning equipment in class. In countries like the US, many schools have rolled out tablets for elementary school children. How they are used depends on the school and the grade. Some educators limit the use to multiple choice tests, while others let students read, write, do research, and presentations on their devices. Despite benefits like instant access to information and interactive learning formats, there are concerns among parents and teachers that tablets, laptops, and smartphones in class reduce children's attention span. Also, studies show that writing by hand instead of typing engages the brain more than simply typing on a computer. Fun fact, in Silicon Valley, tech-free schools are becoming more and more popular, and the people who send their kids there are executives of tech companies. All in all, experts insist in the end it comes down to how we use our gadgets and how much time we spend on them. Alright, now that you're done watching our video, put your device down and maybe go for a walk or talk to an actual person.